Good morning, dear students. Let's start with second session of English Prose Unit 5, The Tiger's Claw. Before we start with the session, let's recall the story of previous session. The story started with the writer sitting in the station waiting room and encountering a tiger. The tiger tries to attack the writer and he recalls all the things of his childhood. The writer tries to save himself by hiding behind the table and furniture. So let's start with the second part of the story. All of a sudden, he sprang up and flung his entire weight on his lot of furniture. I thought it would be reduced to match wood, but fortunately, your railways have a lot of foresight and choose the heaviest timber for their furniture. That saved me. The tiger could do nothing more than perch himself on the roof of the table and hang down his paws. He tried to strike me down, but I parried with a chair and stool. The table rocked under him. I felt smothered. I could feel his breath on me. When the tiger pounced on the writer, he thought that the furniture would break and the tiger would tear him into pieces. Fortunately, the timber used by the railways was good quality and the tiger was unable to get to him. He saved himself by blocking himself with a chair and stool. The tiger was very near him and he could feel its breath. He said, completely covering the top, and went on shooting his paws in my direction. He would have scooped portions out of me for his use, but fortunately, I sat right in the corner, a hair's breadth out of his reach on any side. He made vicious sounds and wriggled over my head. He could have knocked the chair to one side and dragged me out if he had come down, but somehow, the sight of the chair seemed to worry him for a time. He preferred to be out of its reach. This battle went on for a while. I cannot say how long. Time had come to a dead stop in my world. The tiger sat over the table and tried to attack the writer every now and then with its paws. But the writer sat right in the corner so that the tiger could not even touch a hair. The sight of the chair was worrying the tiger, and so he was trying to ignore it. Time had come to a stop for the writer, and he didn't even know for how long he battled with the tiger. He jumped down and walked about the table looking for a gap. I rattled the chair a couple of times, but very soon it lost all its terror for him. He patted the chair and found that it offensive. Here it will not come. You have to cut it, and found it inoffensive. At this discovery, he tried to hurl it aside, but I was too quick for him. I swiftly drew it towards me and wedged it tight into the arch of the table, and the stool protected me on another side. I was more or less in a stockade made of the legs of furniture. He sat up on his haunches in front of me, wondering how best to get me. So the tiger jumped down from the table and searched for a gap from where he could get to the writer. The writer, on the other hand, made a noise of the chair, but the tiger had realized that it would not hurt him, so he tried to throw it away with its paws. The writer made a safety shed for himself by locking the chair in between the table and the stool, while the tiger sat and tried to find a way to get to the writer. Now the chair, table and stool had formed a solid block with me at their heart, and they could withstand all his tricks. He scrutinized my arrangement with great interest, espied a gap and thrust his paw in. It dangled in my eyes with the curved claws opening out towards me. I felt very angry at the sight of it. Why should I allow the offensive to be developed all in his own way? I felt very indignant. The writer had made a solid shed of the table, stool and chair, and it was saving him from the tiger. The tiger was trying to find a gap in between the furniture and he put his paw in. The writer got angry looking at the pause coming through the gap, and he thought that why should everything happen according to the tiger? The long knife from the station master's table was lying nearby. I picked it up and drove it in. He withdrew his paw, maddened by pain. He jumped up and nearly brought down the room, and then tried to crack to bits the entire stocking. He did not succeed. He once again thrust his paw in. I employed the knife to good purpose and cut off a digit with the claw on it. It was a fight to the finish between him and me. He returned again and again to the charge, and I cut out, let me confess, 3 claws before I had done with him. I had become as bloodthirsty as he. Those claws mounted on gold are hanging around the necks of my daughters. You can come and see them if you like sometime. The writer was already angry and noticed a long knife that had fallen from the station master's table. He picked it up, and when the tiger put its paws in between the gap, the writer attacked on the paws of the tiger. The tiger got hurt and was now in pain. It jumped here and there and tried to break the safety shed made by the writer, but was unsuccessful. It tried again to attack the writer, but this time the writer used the knife in a proper way and cut the claw of the tiger. The fight between the writer and the tiger went on. The writer was able to defeat the tiger in the end, and he had also cut 3 paws of the tiger, which he had mounted in gold and hung in the neck of his daughter. So in this way, the writer showed courage and was able to save himself with his mindfulness. So children, with this, we come to the end of our session and the end of this chapter. I hope you all enjoyed the story. Read the chapter from the book. Practice reading every day for better understanding of chapters. Thoroughly and repeatedly go through the videos sent to you. Stay home, stay safe. Thank you.